Hello and welcome to Hoot TV.
This newscast is done by students for students. Today we will look at video games, makeup, and art trip tips.
Also, check out our announcements to stay updated on prom.
Owl's news starts now.
Sofield.
And I'm Valeria.
Welcome to Hoot TV. This newscast is done by students for students.
We hope to bring you all information about the school and helpful tips. Senior, spring is coming up, so that means you have to pay your senior fee, $30.
Prom! Prom registration is now open for the OHS website. Tickets go on sale March 9th. Health officials are in the United States, and they have warned about that the coronavirus is spreading in the country appears inevitable. As of February 25th, there have been 80,238 confirmed cases of the novel coronavirus in 34 countries and at least 2,700 deaths. According to the CDC, 445 people have been tested for the virus as of February 25th, resulting in 15 confirmed coronavirus infections, including two cases resulting from person-to-person spread. In one case of unknown origin, Centers of Disease Control and Prevention said that Americans should prepare for the spread of the corona communities. The World Health Organization is about to declare this virus a pandemic.
Ew.
Relax, it's just the flu.
Do you mean people have died from the flu?
This flu season, three children have died so far in Hamilton County. The most recent death was in January. The Tennessee Department of Health reported the number of pediatric flu deaths across the state have increased to six this week. According to Dr. Paul Hendricks, the specifics of this situation are still unknown, but he advises everyone from the age of six to get a flu shot.
Flu vaccines have been given for more than 50 years, and they have a very good safety track record. Flu vaccines are made the same way each year, and their safety is closely monitored by the Center for Disease Control and Prevention and the Food and Drug Administration. We give over 120 million doses a year in the United States and carefully review the safety.
The following graph of the centers from the Disease Control and Prevention shows that the flu is more dangerous to those under 18, so be sure to wash your hands.
The director of Sharkboy, Lava Girl, Spy Kids, Scary Movies and Scream, The Lord of the Rings, and so many more has been convicted of touchy-touchy assault. Ethan has a lowdown.
Earlier this week, Harvey Weinstein was convicted of rape and criminal sexual assault. In case you forgot, Harvey Weinstein, famous Hollywood film producer, abused his status in Hollywood to solicit and overpower multiple women. He did this for decades before women started coming forward and sharing their stories, sparking the Me Too movement. Since then, over 80 women have claimed to have been sexually assaulted and or raped by Weinstein. With Harvey Weinstein facing up to 25 years in prison, many supporters of the Me Too movement are satisfied. For so long, these women believed that he was untouchable and he can never be held responsible. But now, the criminal justice system has found him guilty, says Tarana Burke, the founder of the Me Too movement. This sends a powerful message to women everywhere.
Other witnesses to testify. So I think the case in this case that we just tried with Mr. Weinstein was a difficult case, no doubt about it. And yet it was a case that we had confidence in that were we to take this to a jury, that the jurors would be able to see through the myths that were thrown up about victims of sexual assault and listen to the women and, as the jurors did, believe them.
Speaking of crime, let's get some safety tips on what to do if an intruder intrudes.
So, Officer Brown, do you have any tips on anything we can do if an intruder comes into the school?
Sure. So, according to 2019 FBI data, only 5 active shooter events have happened in a school. That's 5 more than needs to happen for sure. We don't want anything like that to happen. But just know law enforcement, school administration, our first priority is to keep you safe while you're here at school. So practicing drills, intruder drills, which we've had two so far this school year, and we're going to continue those practices, are the best, you know, safe practices to know what to do in a drill. I would say, you know, if there was an active shooter in the school, get away from the area immediately as safely as you can. If you can get into a classroom, office, bathroom safely, do that. But also, you have the option to exit the building. And we want all students to end up on at Christway, which is located at Amos and Ootowah Georgetown. So that's very important. But, guys, you got to kind of use common sense to know what the best thing to do in the situation, just depending on the circumstances. I can't, you know, answer every what if type of question. So practicing those drills are important. Obviously, if you see anybody suspicious in the building, an adult, student, whatever, if you see something, say something, right? So anything out of the ordinary, speak up, tell an adult, whether it be a teacher, myself, a school administrator, and let us know so we can check it out. We would rather it be nothing and everything continue as normal than something to happen. So that's important. That's about all. I mean, that's the highlights. So
thank you.
Before the break, let's take a look at our birthdays for this week.
Do our best to capture special moments and make them something to remember. And of course, there's plenty of photos and video added to our stories. We share that time with friends, or maybe that's someone special. Prom and graduation season will soon be all the buzz, so much anticipation and promise. But too often, one bad decision can make this a time we wish to forget. Each year, lives are permanently scarred by the consequences brought on by alcohol and drugs. Things happen that can't be undone. And sometimes, those bad things don't just happen to someone else. Don't let one bad decision decide your future.
Junior, your ACT is coming up. These scores are very important to colleges. Let's take an AC tip from Aaliyah. All right.
Can you take a look at our ACT question and tell me what you think the answer is?
Yes, ma'am. I believe number one is A, and number two definitely would have to be C.
Why do you think that?
It just makes the most sense when it comes to literature, and I've had multiple years of experience with writing, so I believe this would be the correct answer.
The first one is C, and the second one is D.
Why do you think that is?
For the first one, you just need the comma after the door, because it's naming parts. And for the second one, it's past tense. Like, he sat on the table in the past, so it would be sat.
All right, thank you.
Number one, it's B, and number two is D.
Can you take a look at the question and tell me what you think the answer is?
Okay, so 1A, 2C.
So A is the correct answer for number one, because the paragraph starts with waiting by the back door, and the rest of the answers have, or the rest of the answers change the semicolon to a comma or have no punctuation there at all. However, the rest of the sentence has the semicolon separating out the next statement, and so it needs to remain a semicolon for the consistency aspect. And then on number two, it would be and a microscope sitting by the on the kitchen table, because was sitting kind of contradicts and makes it more like that would create more of a past tense.
Ms. Flynn, can you tell us some tips for taking ACT, especially like the English portions?
Yes. So one that I always tell my kids is to guess consistently if you get to the point where you have to guess. So instead of jumping around a lot, picking one letter and sticking with it the whole time.
Choo choo! Looks like our owls just bought a one-way ticket to Browtown with our makeup enthusiasts and Hoot Beauty.
Hey Owls, welcome back to Hoot Beauty. I'm Tristan Campbell and Valeria is going to be our makeup artist for today. Our model is
Bailey.
And today we're going to be doing a simple brow tutorial. So let's get started. First, Valeria is going to be picking up an eyebrow brush called a spoolie, and she's going to be using flicking motions with her wrist going up and over to brush out the brows. Now she's going to be taking the dip brow pomade and she's going to line the bottom part of her brow to shape it. If you get too much product on your brush, you can just simply put it, brush the product on your hand so it won't be so harsh and it'll look more natural. Now she's gonna be lining the top of the brow to shape the top. The next part to do is to just fill in the brow so it doesn't just have two lines, it actually looks more natural. To make it more natural looking, you can brush it out with the spoolie so it looks more like hair-like strokes. Next, she is going to be using a flat top brush and concealer to carve out the brow so it looks more sharp. You're just going to be placing the concealer right underneath the brow where you did the line so that it looks sharp and clean. Now she's going to be taking her beauty sponge to blend it out so it doesn't just look like concealer on your lid. It's going to look more natural. And that's it. This is what the final product looks like. Make sure you guys tune in next week for Hoot Beauty, and we'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Risk World Domination is a free game on Steam which was released on February 19th, 2020. The game is categorized as a war strategy game. The objective is to take over the entire world using troops that you are given in a specific country. From there, you have to take over neighboring enemy country. Every turn, you are given three extra troops, and you can add those onto your countries. If you have 9 troops in one country, you can easily take over a country that has 2 or 3 troops. The more troops an enemy country has, you have a higher chance to lose some of your own troops. Taking a whole continent grants you even more troops. You can even make alliances with people, such as, I won't attack yours if you don't attack mine. After you've built your army, you can now take over the entire world. Overall, I give this game about a 4 out of 5 because it still has some things that needs to be fixed, like the lobby system to join your friends, or having to spend tokens just to even play with your friends. Nonetheless, the game is very fun and I highly recommend you check it out. If you're interested in Risk, it's available on PC, Xbox, PS4, and mobile.
Alrighty, Jordan. So tell me, what's the Adventures of Friday and Milford about?
Well, it's about that girl and that two-legged cat is going to the store because they don't have any food, and there's like this strange man that wants to kidnap them. So let's just roll it.
Malford, we're hungry and we don't have a vehicle to get to the store. I don't know what we can do.
Yeah.
Hmm. Well, we might walk there, but I don't know if some weirdo is going to kidnap us. Do you think it's safe, Malford?
Yeah.
Excellent. We might protect ourselves from danger. Malford, are you with me? Stay with me, okay? You know what's out there in these woods.
Meow.
Ooh. What? Who's there? Meow. What the? Greeting, my friend. Now, calm down. I'm her friend. What is your name, little girl and two-legged cat? I am Friday Cornblood, and this is my cat, Meowfer. Who are you? I am Dr. Lim. I am half person and half robot. My limbs got cut off and destroyed years ago. Where are you going, little girl?
Well, I apologize. We don't talk to strangers, and I'm not going to tell you where we are going, sir.
But I never hurt children and their pets. I'm a good man. I will help you. Please trust me. Please.
No, we're fine. We can go on ourselves.
Trust me.
Meow.
Yeah. Oh, little girl.
How do you jump so high?
It's these high-quality springs I invented. Now come with me.
So long, weirdo.
Oh, come on. Come back here. Are you kidding me? Let's go, Malford. What do you like in my store, lady? Can I please get the chicken, the pasta, and the tomatoes, please? It'll be 12:30.
Thank you. That was a crazy day, right, Malford? Don't tell Father, okay?
Meow.
Thank you for tuning in today. We're going to leave you guys with a segment called What's Your Spirit Animal? So what's your spirit animal?
Oh, my spirit animal. Probably a penguin.
Why?
They're really sexy.
What's your spirit animal?
It's a bald eagle.
Why?
Because I love America.
Very nice. What is your spirit animal?
Hippopotamus.
Why?
Because hippos kill more human beings every year than all other animals combined.
Okay. What is your spirit animal?
Probably a bear.
Why?
Because I'm a teddy bear, and I'm very soft sometimes.